guys, and welcome to Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Wildlands. This game I mentioned this summer when I was doing my Guilt series, or games I'm looking forward to. This is the open beta. I will be getting this game on release, which is released on March 7th, so make sure you look out for that on my channel if you do enjoy this. But we're going to jump in today with the beta. I'm not too sure on what to expect. Have already pre-ordered game. You don't need to let me know. I'm just going to turn the brightness up a little bit. Okay, yeah, we don't need to scale it. Let's just get into this. It's a shooter game, as you know, Tom Clancy.
A crude explosive detonated outside.
Let's get into this.
In La Paz, Bolivia. Two Marine Embassy guards were injured in the blast. 2 days later, a CIA asset in central Bolivia provided us with these images. Our analysts have identified the individual in the photo as DEA Special Agent Ricardo Ricky Sandoval, my friend. Sandoval has had spent the last 6 years investigating the local cocaine industry. Our understanding is that Sandoval was the intended target of the bombing. What the embassy bomb did not accomplish was completed up close and personal. Sandoval was captured, tortured, and killed. Then his body was dumped. We have yet to recover it. Our target, the group responsible for the embassy bombing and the death of Special Agent Sandoval, is the drug trafficking organization commonly known as the Santa Blanca Cartel. Yesterday, they were just narcos. Today, they're narco-terrorists. Initially, the Bolivian government resisted the Mexican cartel. They formed UNIDAD, a Bolivian Special Forces unit. It didn't go as planned. Thousands of bodies later, politicians, police officers, and journalists have become an endangered species. The Bolivian government has imploded on itself. With no other options, the new president made a deal with Santa Blanca. You stop killing our people, we'll look the other way. Since then, Santa Blanca has turned Bolivia into the nexus of the South American drug trade. With their friends in Mexico, they also have a clear pipeline to the US and Canada. The only way to stop Santa Blanca for good is to completely dismantle them, piece by piece. The cartel is organized into four operations: production, smuggling, security, and influence. At the top of it all is El Jefe de los Jefes, boss of bosses, El Sueño.
Okay, that's a really good intro to what this game is all about. Very similar to, if you ever seen Narcos on Netflix, like, what's his goddamn name? Pablo Escobar? How did I forget his name? Pablo Escobar, the story of Pablo Escobar, the Colombian drug lord, wanting to get into government, things like that. It's very similar storyline to that, but it's in Bolivia instead. Okay, so you get to create your own character, which is really nice. You can play online, I think, in the full game. I think this is just, I'm not sure whether you can play online in this. So you have the different faces you can choose from here. So, yeah, I mean, I'm not sure what I'm gonna... Snake? Okay, let's get Snake. It doesn't really matter too much. I guess in the full game, we will be changing this. Let's go with Blue Eyes, Lumberjack, Business Beard, Goatee, Trucker. Okay, so there's not, like, a huge amount of options, but it's a nice touch. Hair squared away. No. Shaved ponytail. Undercut. I guess that's my haircut. I mean, I'm just going to try and go for a little bit like me, I guess. Random head. Let's not do that. Face detail. What's this? Eye scar. I have an eye scar. It's not as bad as that, though. Okay. Cool. That's their head. Appearance. So, as you see there, we are. We've got a body details. Facial paint. No, let's not have facial paint. Right arm tattoos. Oh, okay, nice. Sleeves. Some things are locked. I guess you can unlock them deeper into the... Okay, it's mainly sleeves. We have a different one there, but again, it's not a ton. But it's enough to make it look cool. Let's just go with that. Is it the same on the other side? No, they're different on the other side, so... Okay. I'm not sure whether you guys want me to look through this too much, but I guess some people will. So we have a tank top, business casual, going out in the desert with my business casual on. I'm a hoodie. I'm just going to go with tank top, I think. We'll just stay with the tank top just because then we can actually see the tattoos that we've just, stuck on there. Oh, and there's all these different colors you can get as well. Oh, there's actually a lot of different things you can do here. Very detailed. I really like this. But for now, we'll just go with the Molly harness, and we'll stick that black one like that. Fine, that's cool. Pants, different cargo pants there, some jeans, nice, more cargo trousers, a few more options down here. And again, you can change the colors of all of these to whatever you want. Ghillie? No, I don't think we need the ghillie on. We gonna go sniping? I hope so. Love a bit of sniping. Again, there's a ton of options down here, actually. Let's go with the black camo. Let's just do that. Okay, footwear. We'll stick with combat boots. I'm just going to show them just in case people want to see. And this video is going to be probably pretty long. And we won't wear the ghillie suit. Accessories. Eyewear. Wow, look at this. You can actually customize a patch. Oh, that's amazing. You can go full Byron if you want to. I love that stuff. Plastic sunglasses. Okay, let's just go with none. I don't want to have glasses on today. Face wear? A balaclava? No, let's not go that. But again, some people might want to see all of these. I'm just going to go with none. So you can see my hair. Headsets, again, all different headsets. You can, again, customize the different pieces. Let's go with the earpiece. Let's go for, like, CIA. Fingerless gloves. More gloves. Oakley Pilot gloves. Okay, I actually like them ones. And let's put them in black as well. We're going with a black theme here. And then you can choose your different backpack. Drone. Wow, this is actually really cool. I can't wait to get this game, like, full game. And just mess about with all this and finally decide. If you want to see, like, a full... I actually like that one. The Y strap. If you want to see the full game, let me know in the comments. And I'll be bringing that as soon as it comes out, hopefully. Patches? So currently I have none. Oh, that's actually amazing. You can add a little patch to your backpack. How cool is that? How cool is that? Animals? What have we got here? Just eagles because it's all American. Brands? Mainly American flags again. A couple things locked again. You can probably just unlock these later in the... Okay, let's go with that. Doesn't matter too much right now. Okay. How do we, okay, save your character. Cool. Looks really good. Difficulty? I'll go regular. I haven't played the game. I haven't played a shooter in a long while. We'll go regular. We won't go too easy and just blitz through it. We'll go regular. But like I said, if you want to see this, this content as soon as it drops, I will do my best to get it out as quick as possible. Let me know in the comments if you're looking forward. If you're going to get this game as well, we could possibly play together in a group of four. I tried to say before that you can actually play online with a group of four in the full game. And I think you can also play split screen, I think, or something like that. So it's going to be one of the biggest games of the year, I think. Tom Clancy, when a new game drops like this, really, really good. Going to be very detailed. I did do my the games I'm looking forward to thing on it, where I explained exactly what different types you can do. We're going to seem to get a cut soon, so I'm just going to shut up. Helicopter. I can hear a helicopter, so it must be dropping in. Here we go.
The agent they murdered. You knew him?
He was a friend of mine.
Sorry for your loss.
I could say it comes with a job, but it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't.
It's raining and I got my tank top on. Good choice. Good choice.
Get so this down here a while.
I've been living as Karen Bowman, international aid worker, for just about 5 years. Means living rough, but as a cover, it gets me out and about.
At least it comes with a chopper. How'd you get in country? I flew in business class from Manaus. Hey, I'm refreshed and ready for work, right? I just hitched rides from Barranco, Peru. How about you?
I got on board a bus in Huy, Argentina, and drank all the way to Villazón. Nobody wants to deal with a drunk on the bus.
That explains why you smell like ash.
Banter. military banter.
I've heard rumors about you guys. I was a rookie field officer in Moscow when the coup went down. There was talk you were involved?
Nah, it must have been someone else. We were never there.
It's not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
Huh, you should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Is it hard being someone who doesn't officially exist?
You tell me, Karen Bowman, international aid worker.
I'm sure you've seen the horrible, fucked up shit humans are capable of when there are zero repercussions. But let me tell you right now, no matter how you compartmentalize, how you desensitize, you can't prepare for El Sueño.
At the end of the cutscene? I think that's gonna be the end of the cutscene.
He's got a religious streak that reads pretty close to delusional. He's taken vows of poverty, chastity. If he's not in it for the chocha or the money, he's in it for the power. This joint task force is CIA, DEA, JSOC. I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving Unidad and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pakatari, soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
Is this the end of the cutscene? I think it is. So there's different ways you can play the game. We might actually get to meet somebody, as there might be more of this cutscene. Different way you can play the game, you can either do like a stealthy kind of thing, rushing in, sniping from distance, and there's all these different ways you can play the game. So we'll try and test that out as much as possible, as much as we can. But we finally landed here in Bolivia.
Four soldiers. This is the help you promised? That's on the well promised? A single Yankee died. So you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pakatari, leader of the resistance group Qataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There's no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru's one of the founders of the Qataris 26.
More than that, her group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he's in this province and that there is a Santa Blanca lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
Okay, I'll do my best not to kill him before I get to ask him questions. Keep that in mind, that we don't just snipe him from fucking 50 miles away and end up taking out the wrong guy. So, day's gonna change here, and sun's gonna come up. This looks like it might finally be the start of gameplay, boys. And girls, don't discriminate. Okay, we're finally in, so hold X to enter vehicle. So let's take a look around here. You see it's moving pretty quickly.
Time to earn your pay, people. Put on
pretty
your
close in, so let me just see if...
Nope. Yeah, I'm not too comfortable working with Pakatari and these rebels. Their kind of ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. We need to focus and get this done quick before we get stuck between local politics and the firestorm of cartel bullets. First objective, track down that Santa Blanca lieutenant so we can find Amaru.
Okay, so we're going to do a little bit of driving here. I'm guessing it's standard vehicle controls. These guys are fucking running quick. Okay, here we go. So I'm going to be driving. Very similar to, I think, but not like as in the setting. very similar in gameplay to The Division, if you remember that, where you could play online and you could team up and things like that. So very similar to that. We're going pretty slow here. Well, who's this person just like walking along? Oh, the brakes. Brakes are a little bit strong. I guess I'll stick to the road rather than driving in a straight line to the arrow. Okay. So driving obviously isn't the main part of the game, so it's going to be a little bit weird. It's very touchy on the thumbstick to actually move the front end of the car. It looks really nice. I mean, if you look at the game, it's not finished, this version, so it's still a little bit glitchy, if you can see. But I'm sure the final game is going to look beautiful. But this looks good to me anyway. I'm going to just follow this road here. There's another car up ahead. They're over there on that far side. But we're going to keep going. Follow it on the map there down in the bottom right. As you can see, a car coming towards us. And there it is. So we noticed that. We didn't crash into him. So a car coming up behind us as well. An aeroplane flying over the top. So all this you can see on the mini-map. And you're just going to follow that yellow line. Just like on GTA or something like that, where you can just follow the sat-nav line and get to your destination as quick as possible, rather than, you know, getting lost on the way there or taking a wrong turn, which would be terrible to do. But it's an open world. It looks like an open world. You can just go wherever you want. And there's all these different little towns and locations that you can see, and people over here dancing. Not sure what's happening there, but, you know, they're having a good time. So there's all these little things that are going to be happening. If you've ever played Just Cause, or Just Cause 1, 2, I think there might have been a third one of that game, it's similar to that as well, where you're in the sort of jungle environment. There's also town environments and things like that, so it's pretty similar to that in that sense. But hopefully, I mean, I didn't play Just Cause, but that, I think it was a little bit random. This is going to be, I think, a little bit more serious in a game. We're approaching the target here. And I think we're going to have to jump out of our car around here. So let's jump out. We're immediately going to whip up our guns. Hostiles and...
in the area. Stay frosty.
Okay, hostiles in the area. Is that a hostile there? Okay, I've pinpointed him. But do we take him out now? Let's just walk up and see what happens. He doesn't know we're here to kill him. Tutorial. You know what? Skip the tutorial and take a risk. So we've identified one. I can't see any others. I mean, surely he should be able to see me just point a gun at him from 94 meters away. Let's get in the bush here with our friends. And,
don't smoke the target. Switch to suppressors.
Okay, switch to suppressors. I think I have mine on. I can see in the bottom there. I think it switched. So hopefully it switched automatically, which I think it did. If it didn't, we're about to make some noise. I'm creeping up here in these bushes. Not sure how much good this is doing.
Let's move.
Okay, that's the punch. I wanted to crouch, but I don't understand the fall. Okay, remove suppressor. Suppressor is definitely odd. I'm just going to take a shot here through the bushes.
That's a kill.
Okay, so it didn't take much to kill him whatsoever with that. I just sort of shot him once in the head, which is good, because sometimes you shoot somebody and they have a ton of life in these sort of games. And you have to, like, bullet, and then eventually you might take them out. But that would seem to be pretty good. Took him out once, and he folded up into a suitcase. I like that. So let's keep on moving. Anyone in this tower? No, it's a water tower. No one gets inside them. Let's keep moving forward then. Synchronized shot. Tutorial.
I got a target carrying submachine guns. I'm spotting another tango.
Okay, let me take a tutorial here. Shoot or hold A to initiate sync shot. I hope this works.
Target down.
Nope, it didn't work. My, where's my guys at? They're just messing around? You were supposed to shoot him when I shot! I should have checked they was here before I went and did that. I just pressed A on the guy, like it said, and took the shot. There's, I see another guy up there. Is he carrying a rocket launcher or some hay? Either way, we're going to take him out. I mean, I hope it's hay and not that rocket launcher, because we'll be in trouble if it is. Let's keep moving forward, though. This time, teammates get up here. So if I identified one target up there, as you can see, but I can't see any others. No one on rooftops. Anything like that. took him out. Headshot. Nice. So, like I said, a couple of bullets and these guys are down. You don't have to waste too much ammunition on them. You know, if you shoot them, they don't run and hide. And then all of a sudden, you have to be chasing them or they call their friends and things like that. You just shoot them and they're down. But if you miss one... Okay, you can pick up enemy weapons using X. Take a look around here. So they're still 120 meters away. Oh, fuck, dude. That's a kill. That was a little bit sloppy there. I just walked straight into him. He was 20 meters away. And he saw me. No one in these beds? No one taking a sleep that we have to go through? What's this? Some supplies? Oh, nice. I think they know I'm here now. As far as I can tell. I'm just going to creep around this corner. Be careful not to shoot a bird. I heard a foreign voice there. Not sure exactly where it was coming from. We'll get to this edge. Yeah, they definitely know we're here. Oh, teammates. Oh, that was nice. Where are these goddamn teammates at? Okay, he took bullets. Okay, they definitely know we're here, and they're now coming up at us. I'm not sure where my teammates are or what they're supposed to be doing, but it seems to be me on my own currently doing this mission, and all the AI teammates are just walking around behind me. Can I, like, control them? Get back in there. Let me just talk to these guys. Get up here, man. What are you all doing back here? There's nothing to do back here. You need to get up with me. I mean, if you're going to get that sniper out, at least goddamn use it. Looks like I'm going solo in this mission, I'm afraid. The guys, I don't know how to control them. They don't seem to be doing much good. Probably should have used the tutorial then, but we didn't. And we'll keep going forward. A little bit of a moonwalk down these stairs. Probably not the best idea in a combat situation, but we'll try it out anyway. Okay, heard another voice, which means there's got to be another enemy around here somewhere. There's a car just pulled up. Not sure whether that's an enemy vehicle or whether that's just some citizens driving around. I guess we'll find out in a second. Oh, there's storms over there, and that's nice. Cross? What do you mean cross? Are they going to run over here now? Maybe. Still can't see anybody. Am I being too tentative here? Do I just get in there? Can I peek through this window? Is anybody in there? I think this is the building we're going to. Oh, okay. We got him. To say he's supposed to be a gangster, what's he doing?
You asshole. You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. Lo entiendes?
Chill the fuck out, cabrón. What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
I mean, dude, you was literally sat there crapping yourself for at least 2 minutes.
Not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead. Maybe, maybe not. Amaru is a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to take any chances. There's too much riding on this. Let's move.
Okay, let's move. So I think we need to get back in a car. We just take whatever cars we want. I guess so. Just take this car. Boys, jump in. Here they come.
Better not roll this thing.
Let's get moving. The cartel isn't going to wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru.
So the quickest these guys move is when you get into a car. When you're in a combat situation, they just sit around. Hopefully there's some way to control them and actually get them on your side. I remember a game a long time ago where you used to be able to work with your team similar to this. I think it might have been on PC. And you could like tell them exactly where to position themselves and things like that. And it was a really little fun little game. So hopefully, it may have even been a Tom Clancy game, thinking about it, but hopefully it's a bit similar to that, where you can actually instruct them in which positions they want to move in. I'm sure there's been plenty of games like that, but the one that I remember is probably around 15 years old or something crazy like that. So if they could do it by then, they... Oh, look at this. That's nice. A nice little stream down the mountainside. Oh, it's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. So we've got to go and free Amaro. Oh, I'm gonna take this left turn here. Don't miss it. Down the side of the mountain instead of up the top of the mountain. Another person's walking along the side there. Maybe lost. Hitchhiking. Pick them up. Probably some sort of university student on a... on a little breakaway. And here's a few more uni students. What are you guys doing out here? You lost? Good. You deserve to be lost. Get back to England. I haven't seen too many like wildlife or anything running around the bushes, so I don't know if there's like any wildlife you would encounter if you're walking around. I guess that's not the, you know, the main part of the game is to be a world simulator. Oh my god, flying down now, picking up a little bit of speed. The guy told me not to roll it. I'm gonna try to do my best not to. Oh, through the river. Nice, interesting. Haven't killed any civilians yet, which is always good as well. A little bit of a main road here. Oh, we found an actual tarmac road. Almost caused an accident as soon as we got to it. But we've just been driving on mud roads. So he gets off the highway and heads back into the country and finds a little bake shop coming up on a Toyo farm.
Remember, a lot of these Sicarios are ex-military. ID your targets. If Amaro gets killed by a stray round, Operation Kingslayer will be dead in the water before it even starts. Let's go.
Okay, we're here. It's definitely a farm. There's a helicopter. Are these guys... enemies?
Got another tango. Tango number 3.
Okay, we're doing terribly at stealth here. For stealthy approach, press B, crouch and hold, people go prone. Detection arrows indicate who is spotting you. Okay, they're all spotting us. They've already seen us. I think I got him that time, but teammates yet again did not get involved. We're engaging here. We're going full guns blazing, apparently. No stealth. There's only one way we work, and that is shooting people in the face from about 50 yards. Teammates are finally using their bullets as well. Taking a little bit of damage, though, here. New skill point acquired. Let's push up. Wow. What a move. What an actual move. Try to push up there and got completely caught out. Wow, I'm doing terribly. Teammates, I need some help here. I'm doing terribly. Where's the other guy gone?
We're good. You all in one piece?
Hey, que pasa?
Yeah, we got the guy.
Are you Amaru? What's left of him anyway? Come on, I'm getting you out of here.
Okay, we're getting him out of here. Make sure there's no, guys trying to kill him on the way out. Can we use the helicopter? We're just going to take helicopter.
I'll fly.
Get in, boys. We're going in the chopper. Ready to go. Tutorial helicopters. I'm going to take a risk and do what I want to do.
Where are you taking me?
Back to your friends.
Entonces, Pacatari has made his deal with the
malditos. Ooh, we're pretty wobbly out here. Pretty wobbly in the helicopter ride at the moment. I'm gonna go up and over the top of this mountain. If we'd gone in cars, we may have been like tracked down, but because we're in the chopper, I don't know if we're gonna get any sort of conflict on the way back. Yeah, we're taking the chopper over the top of the mountain. These guys are very, very sturdy on this. I'm really flying it terribly, and they're doing a great job of managing to sit on. They didn't even get inside the chopper. They're like, yeah, we'll take a seat out there. I don't understand how they're staying on. Oh, do not crash the chopper. Okay, 1.8 kilometers over here. We can finally see the landing destination. Let's get over there. Take the landing. So, yeah, terrible with stealth buyers at the moment. I would try to do more stealth, because that's the kind of way I wanted to go, in sort of stealth around, but we got caught twice in the opening two missions trying to get in. I got too close to them. We only have the AR at the moment. We don't have any other weapons that I know of. Okay, let's see if we can land this thing. Coming in. Trees are starting to move. Okay, we down? We're definitely not on flat land here. I'm going to try and get a little bit flatter. A bit more of a flat piece of earth. That should be it. That should be that. Okay, boys, let's roll. Oh, motorbikes? Oh, nice. You can use motorbikes. That's awesome. Oh, mini crosses. Are these guys friendly? I mean, he looks kind of friendly.
Yo, I got a weapons case here.
Okay, awesome. That's that done.
Are you hurt? Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons, they had questioning me. Let us see. Their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not... We're not.
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si. Yuri and Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe four. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock.